Hello and welcome. My name is Anthony Heineman, and I had the privilege of teaching opera workshop this semester. And of course, like all the arts, we've had some interesting challenges in terms of safety procedures and mask wearing, social distancing. But we managed to stay safe and we grew as a classroom. And it was also just nice to be able to continue our art form and to have that to look forward to each week. We have about a 35 to 40 minute presentation for you today, and I would be lying if I said that I had a specific theme in mind when I chose this. I really was trying to choose repertoire that kind of best fit the strength of our class and the makeup of our class, which is seven fabulous sopranos. But looking at all of them together, I realized that there's at least one visitor in each scene who knocks on the door, who enters, and during this time of kind of staying home and having fewer visitors, it's kind of a fun theme to think about. So these ladies worked very hard on all aspects this semester of opera, from vocal technique to style to diction to movement and acting and everything in between. And although it stinks to not have a live performance, we are happy to share our work with you in the form of this video. So enjoy. Arr, matey! I forgot that I was going to set up each scene. So in this first scene from Act One of Pirates of Penzance, a group of kind of silly sisters goes to the beach for a Sunday picnic, and they decide they're going to go for a swim and start to take off their shoes when a pirate shows up and freaks them out. The pirate in our scene, we had to get a little creative with our casting. So there's a celebrity appearance who plays Frederick the Pirate, and it's sung offstage by yours truly. And he says basically to the ladies, I'm so desperate that I will accept even the most unattractive of you. The ladies who find him very attractive kind of pretend not to be interested. But one sister in particular says, I will sacrifice my societal reputation and, of course, comfort you, you stranded man. So here is Pirates of Penzance.
Thank you. have a present for you. Remember, poor papas are not as young as we are, and we have come over a rather difficult country.
Oh, but how thoroughly delightful it is to be so entirely alone. Why, in all probability, we are the first human beings who ever set foot in this enchanted spot.
Oh, except the mermaids! It's the very place for mermaids!
Who are only human beings down to the waist.
And you can't be said strictly to set foot anywhere. Tails they may, but feet they cannot.
But what shall we do until Papa and the servants arrive at the luncheon?
Well, we are quite alone here, and the sea is as smooth as glass. Suppose we take off our shoes and stockings and paddle.
Oh, yes, that's the very thing!
Myself upon your notice in this effective but alarming costume. But under these peculiar circumstances, it is my bounden duty to inform you that your proceedings will not be unwitnessed.
But who are you, Sir Speed?
I am a pirate!
A pirate burglar!
Ladies, do not shun me. This evening I renounce my vile profession, and to that end, O pure and peerless maidens, O blushing buds of ever-blooming beauty,
thank you.
This next scene is a retelling of the Cinderella story that we all know by Rossini. And this is the opening scene where the stepsisters get to make their goofy appearance and where Cinderella comes in and tells the story of the king who, above beauty and riches, values innocence and a good heart. So here is Cinderella.
Thank you.
This next scene is from Mozart's The Marriage of Figaro, or Le Nozze di Figaro. And in this Act Two scene, Susanna, who is the maid to the Countess, is trying to cheer her up because the Countess's husband is cheating on her, trying to cheat on her with Susanna. And so the two ladies kind of plot together how can they catch the Count in the act of trying to be unfaithful to the Countess. So their answer arrives when Cherubino, who is a male character but played by soprano Bernadette Grizzle, and they are going to dress the teenage boy Cherubino up in women's clothing so that tonight in the garden, when the Count makes advances on who he thinks is Susanna, they will be able to catch him and teach him the error of his ways.
Thank you.
This next scene is from Henry Purcell's Dido and Aeneas, and although it's in English, it's a little bit of an older form of English, like Shakespeare. And in this scene, the sorceress, the evil sorceress, hates Dido, the main female character. So she calls her two witchy sisters, and the three of them plot to ruin Dido's life. So they decide they're going to dress up their little elf to go and tell Aeneas that he has to leave and go off to battle, which is a lie. So Dido is so heartbroken that she ends up killing herself at the end of the opera. But this scene is just kind of a dark, fun scene where the three witches kind of plot. We are going to finish out this performance with a fun scene from The Merry Wives of Windsor by Otto Nicolai. And it's the same story as the Shakespeare play. So here in Act One, Mrs. Page and Mrs. Ford, who are both married women, they get a letter from the disgusting, lecherous John Falstaff. And when they go to tell each other about it, they realize that he's written them the same letter. And they decide to somehow, in some way, they are going to get revenge on this John Falstaff. Enjoy.
Thank you. Oh, that was the mission.